Hello friends, in this video I will teach you how to make a mouth and animate it with SmartBone. Subscribe to my channel to see tutorials. Using SmartBone, we can easily animate the character's mouth and create different mouth shapes. I will create a new worksheet for making the mouth so that you can better see the steps of making the mouth. I change the name of the created layer to mouth. I draw an oval using shapes. I select the oval with the select shape tool and change its color. I increase the stroke to 20 and make the oval color brown. I set the color red for the stroke. I select the oval with the create shape tool and convert it into a shape. I select the upper and lower points and increase the stroke with the line width tool and by dragging. I select the points of the corner of the lip and reduce the stroke with the line width tool and drag. You can increase or decrease the size of the lips based on your character type. Now I create a new vector layer and name it in mouth. With the draw shape tool, I create another oval for the character's tongue. I will put it in the right place. I create another oval for the teeth and convert it to shape and make it white. I make a copy of the top tooth by pressing Ctrl+C and Ctrl+V on the keyboard. I created this copy for the bottom teeth. Remember, strokes are not needed for teeth. I select the face mode from the effects section and use the eyedropper tool to extract the color of the tongue from this image. I adjust the position of the teeth. Now I select two layers and put them in a group with right click. Now I want to create a mask so that only the shapes placed on the mouth are visible and any part outside the mouth is hidden. I double-click on the group layer. In the masking section, I choose the hide all option. You can see that the extra parts that are outside the mouth were hidden. Now I double-click on the mouth layer and activate this option in the masking section. And I apply. You can see that the mouth was well made. Now I can adjust the position of teeth and tongue. After making the mouth, I create a bone layer to animate the mouth. I put the group layer inside the bone layer. I select the bone layer and create three bones. I select the bones and set their strength to 0 by dragging. I remove their connection to each other with the reparent tool by clicking on the work page. Now select the three bones that are selected, select the bone selection tool and activate the angle in this section to create the range of movement of the bones. From 70 to minus 70. I name the first bone up and down. I also activate the show label option so that we can see the name of the bone. I select the bone twice and click on new action. And I press the OK button. I put the slider in frame 24 and move the bone to the right with the bone transform tool. I choose the mouth layer. I select two points with the select point tool. Now, with the transform tool and holding the shift button, I move the points up. Holding down the shift button is for smooth and direct movement. I double click on mainline. And I select the bone layer again and create a new action. I move the slider on frame 24 and the bone to the left. I choose two punts and move them down by holding down the shift key. I click on mainline again. Now we select the bone layer and test the movement of the mouth. You can see that it works well. We repeat the same thing for the next bones, with the difference that we make a different mouth shape. I leave the name of the next bone open and closed. I create a new action and place the slider in frame 24. I select the mouth layer and change the mouth state. You have to hold the Alt key so that the lips open at the same time. Now I select the in-mouth layer and change the position of the teeth and tongue. I click on mainline. I do a new action again and close the mouth in the same way. Be sure to hold the Alt button to close your mouth. I choose the points of the corners of the lips. I correct the corners of the lips by using the curvature tool and dragging. I click on mainline again and try the bone function. We repeat the same thing for the third bone and there is no need to explain anymore. I will name the third bone as R and L. I create a new action. I move the slider in frame 24 and the bone to the right. I change the position of the mouth. Be sure to hold the Alt button. I click on mainline again. I create a new action. I change the slider in frame 24 and the bone to the left and the shape of the mouth. Finally, I click on mainline. Now we can create different forms for the mouth by moving the bones or combine them together. Remember that these bones are not visible in the final render and there is nothing wrong with that. Thank you for being with me until the end of this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye until the next video.